Hello and welcome back. If this is your first time here, welcome to Game Review with Yorm. I'm Yorm, and today we'll be reviewing the Anacrusis. I put it off for a little bit because I had some trouble getting through the final episode, just because it's really throws curveballs at you at points, this game. I had also been putting it off because I was hoping it would be a more positive review, but as I kept going through it, I just had more negative things to say. So yeah, I guess with that out of the way, let's get into it.
Let me repeat this to see if I've got it straight.
Boris, after studying the alien tech, now believes the aliens are planning an attack on Earth. So we're going to send an escape pod back to Earth with information on the aliens and warn them.
Correct. That is exactly what we're going to do.
So good.
Good. I guess. Let's go.
Controls. I have played a fair amount of the Anacrusis with both controller and mouse and keyboard. I have found the controls fairly straightforward and easy to grasp both ways. I do prefer playing with a controller though, so that's what I'll be focusing more on for this review. While the default controls are easy to grasp, I found the melee setup to be a little bit odd, so I had switched it with the flashlight. The default melee button for the controller is the left analog stick, while the flashlight is the right analog stick. This just made a little bit more sense to me to switch, especially as there is no sprint in the Anacrusis, exactly like the classic Left 4 Deads. The default look speed seems a little slow as well with controller, so I had to up that a little bit, but it is perfectly fine with mouse and keyboard. The controls have consistently been smooth and responsive, with pretty much no other issues for me personally. Gameplay. I have a fair amount to say about the gameplay as I've played quite a bit of the Anacrusis, both in early access and post 1.0 launch. I'm also a huge fan of the Left 4 Dead series and Horde type games, so I still get excited whenever a previous Left 4 Dead dev tries to recreate that magic. Unfortunately, the Anacrusis seems to fall a bit far from that mark. While it seems to fall a bit far, I also want to say that Stray Bombay, the devs behind the Anacrusis, are still providing post 1.0 release support and updates. I will be starting off with my gripes about the in-game AI, as that has caused me the most negative issues thus far. This will include how characters function while not being played, as well as the director. At the time of recording, which is still after the 1.0 release, the AI still seems pretty broken. I play by myself most often, and I end up with the other three characters standing around doing nothing, getting stuck in corners, or actively running away from me into said corners, and away from certain goals, and offing themselves due to fire or missed jumps way too often. It feels like I'm stuck babysitting toddlers, and I've lost a lot of time due to failing missions over and over thanks to my suicidal toddlers. I've currently put over 24 hours into the Anacrusis and have yet to beat the final episode. I feel that in the current state of the game, it's pretty much near impossible to beat the last episode while playing solo. I play on normal difficulty and often end up having to fight off ridiculous amounts of special infected all at once, multiple times. It is not fun basically breezing through an episode to have it suddenly end while having to fight off a horde of common infected with what feels like endless special infected spawning as well. One of my most recent runs had ended with at least two goopers, three grabbers, two brutes, a flasher, and a spawner, plus the common infected horde spawning all at once out of absolutely nowhere. These sort of mass spawns seem to happen way too often for what is supposed to be normal difficulty. There is also no easy difficulty, the only difficulties are normal, intense, and intenser. There also seems to be way too many times when barely any enemies are spawning in. There will be a slight trickle of infected, with maybe the occasional one special infected appearing. It feels like Stray Bombay has just missed that sweet spot and is kinda hovering on either side of it. Character AI also tend to sacrifice themselves a little too often. They really love to stand in fires for just a little bit too long, as well as ignoring the horde around them and any special infected attacking them as they try to revive any other downed characters. More often than not though, this will result in the character's AI attempting the rescue to just end up going down as well. I've had quite a few runs end because the character AI just can't stop sacrificing themselves. Now, moving on from in-game AI, I'll be talking about some of the game design choices. Such as, when you start an episode, you have a health scanner, which is a health kit essentially, but each safe room only has a medical station that heals you like a health scanner, but you know, you can't take it anywhere or anything. This seems a little bit odd to me, especially as previous Left 4 Dead devs, as it seems like it would make more sense having health scanners as well, just because each player can only use the medical scanner once, but not everyone will necessarily need it, and some people may need more than one scan. The RNG for finding health scanners and health boosters in levels isn't always very kind either. The Anacrusis also lacks any sort of pause feature, even whilst playing a private solo game. I've had to walk away from the game for a few minutes at points, only to come back to my character being played by a bot because I've gone AFK. Not only is not being able to pause a bad enough choice in my opinion, it's far worse that even while playing solo you can end up AFK. On the plus side though, this does make the Anacrusis a bit more unique, as you can just watch the game play itself if you so choose. I feel that the matter compilers, which are perk selection stations, are pretty hard to find overall, as I do some general exploring each level, and I usually find under half of the available matter compiler. Under half of the available matter compilers. I get that, you know, you want people to explore the levels a little bit, but I feel like that doesn't exactly work too much in a horde type game, as I personally prefer to kind of run through these, and that's what I love about Left 4 Dead, is it being very easy to run through. Leading in from this, which is the final design point that I'm not a great fan of, is that you're also unable to choose the specific acts to play in each episode. So if your favorite part of the game was the finale in episode 1, you'll need to play through the entirety of the episode just to play through that specific act again. Now for some of the positive points, which are the guns feel and look great to shoot, and I feel like the amount of chargers, which are essentially ammo piles, are pretty much perfectly scattered throughout each episode so far. I don't think I've ever once really ran out of ammo, maybe on a couple of occasions. Grenades seem to be scattered quite a bit throughout each episode as well, and I feel like there might be a slight oversaturation, but that's perfectly fine, as grenades are pretty fun in this game. I like that the general push in horde games has been replaced with something called the pulse shield. While it doesn't do any damage on its own, you can get a certain perk during your runs that will let it do damage, and it provides a 360 degree push when activated. The levels are overall easy to navigate as well, and I believe I've only struggled with finding my way around in one episode so far. Story. I'm not entirely sure how to start this portion of the review. While I felt the story was fairly easy to follow overall in each episode when I had started, some things were said by the characters in episode 5 that had raised some more questions for me. I also want to keep this as spoiler-free as possible, as it was still a fun enough game that I would highly recommend it, especially if you have friends you can play it with, as this will alleviate most of the issues. Boil the campaign down, you play as one of four survivors aboard a ship called the Isolode that has been overrun by an alien infection. Along with surviving, your mission is essentially to investigate the alien outbreak to a degree, stop the aliens from using the deep space travel technology on the Isolode, and send a warning back to Earth about the alien threat. This pretty much sums up the campaign as I've understood. Graphics. I absolutely love how everything looks in the Anacrusis. The guns are all very unique, but still uniform enough with each other that it looks like they all belong on one ship. The retro-futuristic look was very well executed in level design, player outfits, and enemy uniforms. The choice of colors also really helped sell the retro-future space look in my opinion, with healthy amounts of muted pastels and lots of orange, blue, and white. I'm not sure why, but for some reason, orange, blue, and white just makes me think of like a space company. Enemy design is also fairly unique for a horde-type game, with the common aliens slightly reminiscent of Half-Life's headcrabs. They latch onto their victims' heads. The special aliens definitely stand out from the rest, but some do sort of look similar to each other. I feel like this works though, as they could essentially be from the same brood or infected race. These aliens that look especially similar are the Gooper, Grabber, and Spawner. The other special infected on the roster are the Flasher, Brute, an unknown entity, and the Eggs. Each of these special infected look especially unique from each other, but I find the design of the Eggs to be a little silly. They're essentially killer spiked balls. Sound. I love the gunfire in the Anacrusis, but with default settings, I find it tends to stand out a bit too much compared to the rest of the audio in-game. On occasion, with default settings, audio seems to clash quite a bit. The Anacrusis also feels like it tends to lack music or ambient sounds to a degree. Characters also call out special infected quite a bit, especially as each character will call out the same special infected at the same time, and sometimes they will end up calling it out more than once, and with the amount of special infected that the game tends to throw at you at different points, this gets quite annoying very fast. The music that is supposed to play when a horde is coming doesn't seem to start up every time as it should, which can make it a little jarring when a horde seems to come out of nowhere. It also seems to start playing on small occasions where there's no horde to be found, so this can make it a little bit tense for no reason. Overall, even with all the frustrations, I would still recommend the Anacrusis, especially if you have friends to play it with. As I have said before, this alleviates a lot of the problems. You can also play it with randos online, but I personally prefer just going it solo. I have my fingers crossed that Stray Bombay will fix some of the issues I feel are in the game over time, or that some mods will pop up to help improve some of these things. There are some pretty great level mods out there already as well, but I was unable to find any to improve character AI so far. The Anacrusis has probably also been one of my favorite horde type games, right under the Left 4 Dead series, which is 1 and 2, and World War Z. Alrighty, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did like it, leave a like. If you disliked it, leave a dislike. Maybe leave a comment or subscribe if you feel like it. I will be doing more reviews, trying to do it more often. I think my next one will either be the coin game, which I'm pretty sure is a very indie game. If I remember correctly, it's by a single developer, or Subnautica Below Zero. So thanks again, and we'll see you later.